In this video, we are going to discuss about interfacing with 8085 microprocessor. Generally, interfacing is nothing but connecting outside peripherals to 8085 microprocessor. We are going to connect these peripherals by using two modes. Those two modes are memory mapped I/O mode and I/O mapped I/O mode. So, in memory mapped I/O mode, I/O devices are also treated as memory devices, whereas in I/O mapped I/O mode, so both memory and I/O treated separately. So here I'm going to discuss some characteristics. So here for memory mapped I/O and I/O mapped I/O, you can take this as difference. So the number of address lines here we are using is 16 for both memory and I/O, whereas I/O is treated as memory only. So here, coming to I/O mapped I/O mode, for memory we are using only 16 address lines and for I/O we are using 8 address lines. So here for I/O we are using less address lines and for memory we are using all 16 address lines. Coming to control signals, as we are using I/O is also as memory chip, we are using same control signals which are using for memory. That means to control this memory, whatever you are using, same signal we are using for I/O, because we are using I/O as memory only. So here MEMR refers to memory read and MEMW stands for memory write. These read and write control signals are used for both memory and I/O operations. Now coming to this I/O mapped I/O, here as we are taking memory and I/O separately, here we are having four different control signals for read and write of that particular memory and I/O. You know that to read or write the memory, you require MEMR bar and MEMW bar. But to read and write I/O, you require IOR bar and IOW bar. That means I/O read and I/O write. All these control signals are active low. If you observe these signals, you can identify a bar. So that means those are active low. Whenever they got 0 at its input, they are going to control a particular operation. So now, number of peripherals, coming to the number of peripherals, so it can be dependent upon the size. So we can connect up to 64 KB, so both for memory and I/O. For example, if your memory interfacing is 64 KB, you need to consider I/O as 0. For example, if you are taking 50 for memory, so you need to consider remaining 14 KB for I/O. So like that you need to consider. So coming to here, so for memory we are having 64 KB. So for I/O we have access up to 2^8. That means 256 I/O devices we can connect. So 256 I/O devices we can connect. So now coming to number of advantages. So coming to advantages, here you know that you are not using your I/O. I/O is also used as memory in memory mapped I/O mode. As you are not using your I/O, so then IOM signal is not required. Why? Because so generally this is a signal to identify the write or read operation is related to either I/O or memory. Here I/O and memory both are used as memory, means no need to identify whether that equation is related to that I/O or memory. Then definitely your I/O and M bar signal is not required. So separate instructions are not required. So that implies separate instructions are also not required. Second advantage is arithmetic logical operations we can directly perform on I/O data. So as we are using I/O as memory directly, so we can perform arithmetic and logical operations on I/O data directly. So coming to the advantages of this I/O mapped I/O mode, interfacing is less complex. So that means, so here as we are using separately, we are having some clarity. So interfacing is not that much complex. So this is less complex for interfacing, and maximum capacity of microprocessor is utilized in this mode. So now coming to the disadvantages of both modes. So coming to memory mapped I/O mode, the disadvantages are interfacing is complex because we need to get clarification about which is I/O, which is acting as memory, and what is the actual memory. So that's why interfacing is complex and memory space required is high. So we require high memory space as we are using I/O is also as memory. So we require memory as high. So here coming to I/O mapped I/O, I/O devices require separate instructions here. Why? Because we are not using I/O as memory, we are using I/O separately. So separate instructions are required to read or write I/O. So I/O devices require separate instructions. This may be one of the disadvantage of this I/O mapped I/O mode. When instructions are increased, time will increase. So arithmetic logic operations cannot be performed directly on I/O data. Here as we are not using I/O as memory directly, we can't perform arithmetic and logical operation directly on I/O data. Coming to third disadvantage, four control signals are required. If you observe here, the number of control signals are 4 here, but in memory mapped I/O mode, the number of control signals are 2 only. So MEMR, MEMW is both is used for both memory and as well as I/O. Why? Because I/O will also act as memory here. Now, so the main disadvantage is we require 4 control signals here and separate instructions are required to activate that I/O devices which are connected to microprocessor. This is nothing but interfacing and memory mapped I/O and I/O mapped I/O.